Good morning. Bobby, could you please read the problem? And Billy, could you please translate?
Flippin' physics.
What is the angular acceleration of a compact disc that turns through 3.25 revolutions while it uniformly slows to a stop in 2.27 seconds?
Okay, angular acceleration, or fishy thing...
Alpha.
Equals, question mark... change in angular position is 3.25 revolutions. However, we need to convert that to radians, so multiply by 2 pi radians over 1 revolution to get 6.5 pi radians. Angular velocity final is 0 because the CD stops, and change in time is 2.27 seconds.
Bo, please solve the problem.
Well... we know we can use the uniformly angularly accelerated motion equations because the CD slows down uniformly. However, none of the U alpha M equations have all four of those variables in them.
We need to solve for angular velocity initial first, and then we can solve for angular acceleration.
Okay. So angular displacement equals 1/2 times angular velocity final plus angular velocity initial times change in time.
Or 6.5 pi equals 1/2 times 0 plus angular velocity initial times 2.27.
That means omega initial equals 2 times 6.5 pi divided by 2.27, which is 17.9915 radians per second.
Billy, please continue the problem.
We use the equation definition of angular acceleration. Fishy thing equals change in angular velocity over change in time.
Actually, we should use the U alpha
fishy
M equation. Angular velocity final equals angular velocity initial plus angular acceleration times change in time.
No, we should clearly use the definition.
Actually, no, we need to use the U alpha M equation.
Definition?
U alpha M.
You are so wrong.
Me?
Yeah, right. You are wrong.
U alpha
I
M.
I don't think so.
Are you both delirious and daft? They're the same thing.
No way.
What?
That's not possible.
This feels familiar.
Bobby is correct. If you start with the equation definition, angular acceleration equals change in angular velocity over change in time, you get angular velocity final minus angular velocity initial over change in time. Multiply both sides by the change in time, and you get angular velocity final minus angular velocity initial equals angular acceleration times change in time. Bring the initial angular velocity over to the other side, and you get the uniformly angularly accelerated motion equation, angular velocity final equals angular velocity initial plus angular acceleration times change in time.
I could be down with that.
I'll be.
Very nice, Bobby.
Okay, I'll finish the problem. Angular acceleration equals angular velocity final minus angular velocity initial, all divided by change in time. So that is 0 minus 17.9915, all divided by 2.27, which is negative 7.9258, or negative 7.93 radians per second squared, with 3 significant digits. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.